when I started talking to my coworkers, they told me they've been living in these states for their whole lives and they've never seen anything like that.
One of the rarest creatures in Florida captured on the doorstep of a home in Golden Gate Estates. You can see a Florida panther peeking inside the family's window. These panthers are critically endangered and extremely elusive.
NBC2's Ryan Arbogast is talking to that homeowner who caught it all on camera.
Most people living in rural Golden Gate Estates will never make contact with a Florida panther. FWC says there's only about 200 living in our area right now. So when a family felt the cold stare of one going from their door, they picked up their phones and they called us.
And all of a sudden, I just get this intense feeling of feeling that something is staring at me. So really quick, I just look over and there he is, just staring me out, kind of looking like he wanted some popcorn and joined the movie.
You are looking at a Florida panther who just wants to watch a movie with Vandella Harold and her family through the sliding glass door of their Golden Gate Estates home along 12th Avenue Southeast. They just moved to this area less than 2 months ago.
Oh yeah, he welcomed me for sure. He did not look very cute and cuddly, more like he wanted a snack. So if I would have been outside, I would have been scared for my life.
Our crews took this video to the experts at Florida Gulf Coast University to see what they would do in this wild situation.
I guess the first thing I would do is appreciate the moment. You know, we don't have that many opportunities to see these charismatic animals so close to home.
According to FGCU biologist Nora Demers, panthers pose virtually no risk to humans. But small animals like the Harold family's three dogs are another story.
Of course, you want to keep your animals under control because they are considered, you know, they're prey for the panthers.
Luckily, everyone is safe, and the panther eventually moved to checking out the front yard and nearby areas.
I was worried about my dogs because I have three dogs, so I did not take them out for a few hours after that.
If this situation ever happens to you, make sure you find your small children and pets and head inside slowly. If you are to run, FWC says that could trigger the panther's fight or flight instinct, making them more likely to chase you. I'm reporting local today in Golden Gate Estates. Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.
Florida panthers are found primarily in the Big Cypress National Preserve and the Everglades, this shaded region of South Florida, including Collier, Lee, Hendry, and Miami-Dade counties. As Ryan mentioned, scientists think there are approximately 200 left in the wild. In the early 1990s, there were only about 30 cats left. Many of them had serious defects because of inbreeding. The population rebounded only because the state released 8 female Texas cougars into the wild in Florida. Cougars are close cousins of the panther, so their genetics matched. The biggest threats to Florida panthers now are habitat loss and getting hit by cars. That's the number one killer. On average, about 30 panthers are found dead on the side of Florida roads every year over the past decade. But that number has been dropping. That's good news. So far this year, only about 4 panthers have been found dead on the side of the road, all in Collier or Hendry counties. Florida's Protect the Panther license plate is getting a new look this year. FWC just released this plate last month, picture of the mother panther and her cub from 2018. This was a famous picture because it captured the first known female panther north of the Caloosahatchee since 1973. The money from purchasing one of these license plates goes directly to supporting the research and management of Florida panthers. It will be available later this year.